Greetings, nerd fam, and welcome back to NVIDIA GTC here in our beautiful nation's capital, Washington, D.C. My name is Savannah Peterson, here with exclusive coverage on theCUBE. Very excited for this next segment with a CUBE regular and fan favorite, Kevin from Vultr. Kevin, thank you so much for coming to hang out.
So great to see you again, Savannah. So happy to speak with you.
Yes, likewise. Love the big hug when we come in. It's like it's a whole family affair here in Nerdland. Nerds are really having a moment. How's the show been for you so far?
The show's been amazing. So many customers, so many partners, a lot of energy here on the show floor. And it's just been amazing because what we're launching here today is our support for the public sector. We just launched our FedRAMP roadmap. And so we're having some wonderful discussions with public sector agencies on how we can help accelerate their AI initiatives in 2026.
Which I bet a lot of people are talking about. You know, I was even telling Brendan, our producer, as we walked over, I think you might have had the most full booth of the whole show floor today.
Yeah, I was actually originally worried, I'll be honest with you, because we had so many of us here at Vultr actually attend the show, and I had a little bit of concern, like, would we have people...
Is it overwhelming?
But actually, we were packed from, like, from the opening all the way to the close. Everyone was fully engaged. I don't think any of us had 5 minutes to spare to even go to the restroom, to be honest.
Wow.
Yeah, it was pretty awesome.
So break down the announcements for us a little bit, clearly driving a lot of craving from the community.
Yeah, so I mean, I think in Jensen's keynote, he made some really good points about the need to strengthen our national AI infrastructure and leverage AI to have greater resiliency in our public sector agencies. And so here at Vultr, we've been working very hard for a number of years to continue to lead in security and compliance and to advance our FedRAMP roadmap. And so what we announced on Monday was our new public sector vertical and our new support for federal and state agencies with our FedRAMP and GovRAMP roadmap so that we can start working with people now, here, today, in Q4 for all of the initiatives they need to roll out in 2026.
No wonder you've been so popular.
We were pretty packed.
Yeah. So how long have you been working on this and developing this?
So we've been working on our AI infrastructure since the, you know, early days of, you know, AI. We were the first to fractionalize the A100. We were one of the first to market with the H100. And we've been building the most resilient, secure, compliant AI infrastructure at global scale ever since. So that's actually the map here that you're seeing.
I was going to say,
exactly,
talk to us about this.
Because Vultr, you know, we're not just a neo cloud. We're a full public cloud platform. We're a hyperscaler. We're an alternative to AWS, Google, or Azure. So we have the same global scale, 32 global data center regions across all six continents, you know, reaching 90% of the world's population in as little as 2 milliseconds. It's absolutely insane.
90% of the world's population in 2 milliseconds?
As little as 2 milliseconds. Anywhere between 2 and 40. I think the average is sometime like 10 milliseconds. But the performance is out of control, right? And then most recently now what we're doing is we're making certain that we can offer that to federal and state agencies and meet their stringent requirements
around deployability for federal workloads. That's what I was thinking. I can imagine, you know, designing for tech companies moving at velocity is a lot different than these public sector institutions.
Very different. And so in order to get that FedRAMP compliance, you know, this is something that you don't just do in 1 year, 2 years, or 3 years. This is the multi-year journey.
That's kind of why I was asking about the timeline.
Exactly, yeah. Multi-year journey. So we've been working on our security and compliance since day one. You know, we have a 10-year operating history supporting over 300,000 customers. You know, we're used to protecting our customers, protecting their data, and protecting our network against malicious threats. And so now we're taking it the next level, and we've been working for a little over 3 years on our FedRAMP roadmap, and so we're so excited that that's coming to culmination here in Q1 of 2026. And what's really critical about this is, in this day and age of, you know, AI infrastructure, you have a lot of newer providers that raise a lot of money, and they buy a lot of GPUs, and now they're renting those GPUs out to you. And, you know, the security, the compliance, you know, you have to wonder, like, how secure, how compliant are these things? Because you can't just, you know, get all of the certifications and the multi-years of experience overnight.
And that really comes down to trust. I feel like that's one of the linchpins of all the collaboration partnerships and announcement right now. How do you continue to foster a culture of trust when you're moving at this velocity and integrating these new customers?
I think it was amazing what Jensen did on the keynote because he talked about the process of co-creation. So we do a lot of co-creation. So everyone here is in some way, shape, or form our partner. So we work closely with them. So as we're innovating, we're learning their roadmap and we're co-engineering and co-creating entirely new solutions. Like for example, we were just here with NetApp. And NetApp, you can actually see their demo right over there, which is we are co-creating a reference architecture based on their NVIDIA reference architecture so that we can enable NetApp customers to safely and securely, it's called FlexCache, you know, their on-prem data into our cloud data center regions for all of their AI initiatives. So the trust comes from building strong relationships. The trust comes from being open, transparent about the requirements that we're solving for and the help that we need to engineer a joint solution for our customers. That's why I think we were also packed, because it wasn't just customers coming by our booth, right? I'd like to think our booth was awesome, but it was actually all of our partners were bringing their customers to our booth. It was kind of cool.
How good does that feel?
It's super fun. I mean, we love our partners. They're like we know them by name. Like, you know, we love seeing them at these shows and we do a lot of stuff together. Just, we feel really warm about our partner community and our ecosystem. And, you know, thank you all to all of our partners out there. We love working with you. You guys are just amazing and we love sharing your stories.
And how could you not want to work with Kevin with that attitude? My goodness. Talk to me a little bit about how you bring these partners into the fold. You know, I realize the strong relationship building is key, but this is going to be really tricky for you, especially
it's
now that
it's very tricky
rolling out in this sector.
It's very tricky. And Savannah, we thought long and hard about how we do this. And what we came to realize is that there was no way a cold call will work. So we invented this cute little plushie. His name is Morty, and he is a bird of death. He is an angry bird. But he's also very bouncy and very fun. So what we do, and you might have seen as I stand in every conference in the center of a room, and I take this bird and I throw it at people. And when they catch it, then I say, now you need to talk to me. And that's how we built our partnerships. That's how we built our, I'm actually not kidding you.
Wow, that's I'm how so we, glad I asked.
That's literally how we got introduced to many of our partners. We literally took this bird and we threw it at them. It's pretty true. It's actually how we do our customer acquisition too. It's the lowest cost of customer acquisition in the industry. Everyone talks about all this crazy digital marketing stuff and, you know, their cost per MQL. I was like, my cost per MQL is zero. I take a plushie and I throw it at a customer and they grab it and next thing you know,
I mean, it's maybe customer, $199 for the plushie, let's be fair.
Well, okay, it's $199. Yeah, they're a customer for life.
Yeah. Okay, wait, this is so amazing. I'm so glad I asked.
It's actually true. You see me, like you'll see me. I will literally be out there throwing this, trying to get new partners. If I want to talk to you, I will throw one of these things at you.
Oh my gosh. That's true. This is amazing. So you're basically fishing with
birds. Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Wow. Okay. That is awesome. I can't wait till we have one of your partners on next and I'm gonna ask them if they got nailed with one of these. And that's how it all became possible. So how, with everything going so fast, you guys are doing a lot. I mean, you're absolutely crushing it. I was saying that when I walked up to you. How do you decide what's next on the product roadmap and what's that tension like internally?
Right. So here's another little secret is like, you know, all fun aside with this, we also do a tremendous amount of technical documentation. So, you know, we're not just marketing here at Vultr. We also run all the technical documentation. And so we have a community of, like, I think it's like now 497 people that we work with as creators, and these creators actually tell us as an ongoing focus group the problems that they're trying to solve in AI infrastructure. And so we have an entire system to collect their input, get all the topics that they want to talk about, and then produce technical documentation to solve those problems. And in going through that process, we recognize gaps. Because we identify,
it's really smart, actually. It's,
and I can show you our technical doc. You can go to see it yourself. docs.day.com. docs.day.com. That's an old company of mine. That was from
shout out to all of Kevin's old colleagues.
Yeah, exactly. Love you guys, Day Software.
Yeah.
Now Adobe. but docs.vultr.com. You can go to docs.vultr.com. Everything you see there is actually co-created with some random AI researcher, some random developer out there in the wild. And so we have this constant ongoing focus group collate ideas. It's actually, it's an incredible engine.
Yeah, and what a good source of community building, too.
It's our whole community as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why they love the stickers. I see all these wonderful stickers that you have on your laptop. You know, we run hackathons all around the globe, and so our creators actually come to our hackathons, and we have different stickers for different countries that we do hackathons in, and the fun thing is you want to collect all the stickers. You got to collect all the stickers because they're all unique.
Do you have a favorite sticker?
My favorite is Morty Tuk Tuk. So Morty's in all the stickers. So for the last hackathon series that we did in India, we did it in Delhi, in Mumbai, in Bangalore. Okay. We have Morty on a Tuk Tuk sticker, and it's kind of cool.
That is kind of cool. They love it.
Yeah, they love it. They're
wild for it. And it makes those geographies feel included in your thoughtfulness.
You are 100% right. So I think this day and age of AI, I think we need to, you know, be more attentive to inclusiveness.
Because we don't, louder for the people in the
because
back.
Because we don't want anyone left behind. And we want to uplift all societies. We want to uplift all people and reskill and retool a modern workforce here in the United States and elsewhere around the globe. And so that's why we run hackathons all around the globe. That's why our creator community is all around the globe. That's why Morty goes all around the globe to connect with everyone wherever they live and work.
And to fly into your lap.
And to fly into your lap.
Unsuspectingly. I love that you just brought that up. How, beyond the hackathons and the stuff that you're doing as a company, how do we as technologists and an industry, how do we do this? How do we make sure we don't blow this?
You know, it's a really good question. I don't actually know if I have the right answer, but what I firmly believe is that we need to all have an attitude of, you know, seeking to drive positive change. Yet we want to drive the bottom line. We want to drive revenue. We want to disrupt industry. You know, we want to do all of those things. But let's have a purpose.
Yeah.
Let's know why we want to do that stuff. We want to uplift people. We want to uplift our society. We want to make the world a better place. So let's use the power that's being unleashed here at NVIDIA and by Jensen. Let's use it for good.
Yeah.
And I think if we all have that mindfulness of like why this moment's important for the human race, actually.
Totally.
You know, just have that in mind. So I don't know if that's the right answer. I don't know if there's any prescriptive way
to
make that happen.
Answer.
But it's just, it's a philosophy that we have here at Vultr, you know, care about the outcomes you're driving and make the world a better place.
I love that. I really, really wish, I really hope, I shouldn't project bad things on people, but I really hope everyone is as mindful as you and your team are when it comes to what's happening right now, because it doesn't take much for it to get a little weird real fast.
We agree.
Speaking of inclusion and flexibility, you all allow your customers to go in between NVIDIA, AMD, lots of different things. Talk to me about that.
So we firmly believe in a multi-cloud, hybrid cloud world. So we want to be inclusive of all of the existing technology that you may have already deployed in the cloud. So this means that we'll connect your data centers with our data centers. We'll connect your services from Amazon or Google or Azure. We'll leverage your existing CPU infrastructure. We want to support a heterogeneous world because we believe that all enterprises are always going to have a heterogeneous infrastructure, and we want to bring it all together, marshal it, and bring it forward into this new age of AI. And I think actually that's also part of our secret sauce, because I think we're the only ones that really kind of get how to do that quickly and easily and cost effectively.
And it's complex for most people.
And it's super complex.
Yeah.
Like the security, the networking, it's really super complex. It was actually the subject of my talk here today at GTC was how to, you know, scale up, scale out, and, you know, scale globally. And this was actually part of the actual discussion. And I'd love to walk you through the presentation later.
Ooh, I love that. Nice little pitch.
Yes.
You really are a good marketer, Kevin.
I try.
Yeah. So what do you think is going to come next? What's going to be the exciting thing that comes out of some of these collaborations that you're working on, or the next big milestone that society gets to feel, not just us here in Nerdland?
Well, we're actually demoing that here at our booth, funny enough, which is, you know, everyone's all about vibe coding.
Right.
So what if you could vibe code your AI infrastructure. What if deploying your AI infrastructure was as easy as talking to Morty and saying, hey Morty, I'd like to spin up 1,024 B200 GPUs in Atlanta and Delhi. Can you make that happen? Yes, I can make that happen. They're now deployed for you in your account. Or maybe ask a question. Hey Morty, I'd like to spin up a healthcare agent that I could deploy in my existing healthcare portal that's running on in my account. What do I need to do that? And Morty will tell you, you're gonna need the following GPUs in the following locations. You're gonna need to have the following RAG pipeline set up and configured with NetApp. And then Morty will say, would you like me to set that up for you right now in your account? Yes, Morty, please do that. And we actually have that running right here in our booth.
That is amazing. We're gonna have to get a little
vibe coding AI infrastructure. Why should it be any harder than issuing typing into a prompt?
And it should be all NLP, to your point.
That's all NLP.
Which is so important as we think of an inclusive future.
How's my latest training run? It's 70% complete. Thank you, Morty. Can you notify me when it's done? Yes, I can.
Vibe coding AI infra through a bird. It was not on my bingo card for GTC DC, but coming from you, I'm not even remotely surprised. What application of AI has you most personally excited right now?
Oh, that's really interesting. So I think actually this thing that we're doing, the vibe coding AI infrastructure, we've been working on it for a while.
Yeah.
It's using, it's the latest agent-to-agent protocol and MCP protocols. Like, it was actually a pretty heavy lift because we were some of the early adopters of this stuff a while ago. So I'm pretty excited about that. But I'm also really excited about how we're using AI for our creator community, actually.
Yeah.
So what we're doing is, again, we use our creator community as kind of like an ongoing focus group to source topics of things that are relevant to them and so on and so forth. And so what we want to do is we want to vastly expand the resources available to them. So, for example, we might write 10 articles on different ways to configure different mesh networks to set up hypercloud infrastructure. But our creators might just want to ask a simple question. And so what we want to start doing is, from all of our existing documentation, generate a personalized document, which is the union and summary of all of our collective knowledge that you can just follow. So as opposed to giving you 10 things to read, give you one document, one thing with all of the code.
Streamlined.
All streamlined. Let's make it easy for you. And I think it's going to transform the way we do our technical documentation. Like, we're going to just give you the step-by-step for the exact problem you want to solve. Step-by-step-by-step, how do you solve that particular problem?
Awesome.
So it's going to be awesome. And then at the end of the day, at the end of the document, guess what you can do? Tell Morty to just do it.
Exactly.
And then Morty just sets it all up and configures it for you.
This little bird is doing a lot of work.
This little bird's a powerhouse.
Yeah, this is, don't underestimate the size.
Don't underestimate the size.
This is serious.
This is very serious.
All right, last question for you. When we're at GTC in March, back in California, what do you hope to be able to say then?
Oh, that's going to be big.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the GTC in March is going to be huge.
It's going to be crazy.
It's going to be huge.
What do you hope to be able to tell me then that you can't yet tell me today?
I actually do have to withhold answering that particular question. I do think that the Vultr you see today is not the Vultr you're going to be seeing in March.
Ooh. Okay, folks.
My words.
Yeah, that's going to be the soundbite for our GTC teaser. That's for darn sure.
Stay tuned. Register for GTC 25 to 26 right now. It's coming to San Jose this March 17th through 19th.
I love that he already knows the dates. You can, if it doesn't work out at Vultr, you can always go work at NVIDIA. Oh, Kevin, it is seriously always a pleasure. I look forward
to
sharing
to
time
see
with you. Yes, so fun. And I'm glad I'll get to see you in Atlanta at
awesome.
As well. Thank all of you for tuning in to our fantastic exclusive coverage here in Washington, D.C. At NVIDIA GTC, my name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.